Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp partner. Yesterday, Mailchimp introduced its new surveys functionality and it is awesome. We can now create a survey, a full survey with questions that people can respond to in Mailchimp itself. In the past, we could create what was called a poll or a survey, but it wasn't really that powerful or intuitive. Typically, people were using Typeform, Jotform, SurveyMonkey or others, but now we can create those surveys in Mailchimp itself, and I'll show you how. As you can see, I'm in Mailchimp and I'm viewing my audience. To get to surveys, I view my audience or I click audience in the menu bar and then click view contacts. You'll notice there's a new surveys link or button in the menu bar, so I'll click that. And I'm now able to either create a new survey or if I already have created surveys, I'll see them here. So we can have multiple surveys. So to create my survey, I'm merely going to click create a survey. I can now see various information about the survey itself, but I click Edit Survey. There are now two main tabs. One is the questions, in other words, the questions we want to ask people to get their response to the survey questions. And the other is the design, the colors, etc. So let's start with the questions themselves, and quite simply, we follow the instructions. So we click Add a Question to add a question. And what we can do at this stage is change the name of the survey. So I'll call it here, let me just call it organicweb.com.au demo. Okay, so what would we like to ask? There are various different types of questions we can ask. Radio buttons, check boxes, open text, 0 to 10 range, and email. So radio buttons is the good old, as we know, the radio buttons. Check boxes, where people can select multiple. Open text, where a person can add free text. 0 to 10 range, as you can see here, so they can select, you know, I rate your service as a 10 or a 1 or whatever. And we can ask people even for their email. So let's start with the email, for example. So we can type our actual question. And you'll notice on the right-hand side, we have various options, such as, is this a required field? And if it's an email type of question, we can ask them if they want to subscribe. Let me explain what happens in this case. If the person does say they want to subscribe, so let's just type here, subscribe me. So when a person enters the email address, they'll be able to check this box. So if a person checks this, they'll be added to your audience with an email status of subscribed. In other words, you'll be able to send them email marketing. If, however, the person enters their email address into this question but does not click this option, they'll be added to your audience, but there will be an empty value in the email status field. In other words, you'll be able to advertise to them, even send them a postcard and so on in Mailchimp, but you won't be able to send them email marketing. Okay, so that's the email address, for example, and we can scroll down a little bit. Sorry, excuse me. And we can click add a question. What would we like to ask? So let's just ask one more question, for example. Let's do radio buttons. And let's do, what is your fave color? And we'll do that in Australian spelling, color in Australian spelling. And let's put here red. Let's add, we'll click enter to add another option, blue, green, and we'll add an other option so they can select their own color. And again, we can make this required. There are, for every question, there are options on the right hand side we can check. We could add more questions, but let's just pretend this is our entire survey. We'd now go into the design tab, and you'll notice that Mailchimp continues to save your changes as you move forwards. We could add our branding. We could include our logo if we wanted to. We could even add a description. Let us know your favorite color. Sorry to you Americans, but this is Australian spelling in this case. We could add custom messages, such as the default text on the button is submit, but we could change this to send, for example. We could add a custom confirmation message. When the survey is closed, we could add some text in, but let's just click back here and we'll change some of the colors. So let's say we want to change the color, and just for this example, let's just use a strange reddy sort of color just so that we can see it. It's obvious. And maybe we want to change the button color. You could change that as you see fit. But now let's pretend we're happy with the survey. We'll click save and close. And at any time, of course, we could go back to all surveys. We could even click audience, view contacts, and surveys. And you can see my survey there. So I'm going to click view. So we've created our survey, we've styled our survey, but what we haven't done is actually made it live. So the way we make our survey live is by clicking turn on. So this makes it live on the web. So what our survey is, it's a bunch of questions, I guess, on a unique URL. So we can't send the questions themselves in an email, but we can host them on a unique URL online. Email broadly does not allow for having questions and allowing the submitting of those the answers to those questions. So we have to host the survey on a unique page. We've got various default options here. We could share on Twitter, share on Facebook. We could view the page, which I'll show you in a second. We could even copy the URL. Now, if we click share by email, which I'll do, Mailchimp gives us two types of links we can create to send from an automation or from a regular Mailchimp email campaign. So link with, automatic response attribution. So in other words, this would, if we're sending to a person that's already in our audience and that person replies, we'd be able to link their responses to the email address. If you want to make this private, you would share this this link, sorry. Okay. But the other way is we could copy the survey URL. To see our survey, I'm going to click view page. And our survey will come up. So here's our very basic survey. So let me enter, some answers. Actually, just bear with me. I'll just change this email a little bit. I've done a bit of testing. I could subscribe, or maybe the person will subscribe themselves. What is my favorite color? Blue, for example, and send. So this is what the end user or the person you're sending the survey to will see. So back in Mailchimp, I'm just going to refresh and just reiterate where I am by clicking audience, view contacts, surveys, because now we want to see the responses to our survey. So I'm going to click, I could click view or just click on the name of my survey itself. Of course, I could create a new survey, but I'll click on the name. And we can see that one person has responded to this and a very brief summary of the results. But we can dig deeper and click view all responses. And we can dig down. So it makes it nice and pretty. We could click on one of the answers and we can see that demo plus five answered that question. What we can also do at this time is even tag people to the answers they responded. So let's say this was for an event. We could say, are you interested in attending? And the people that respond yes, we could then tag them. In other words, add a tag in our audience saying, yes, these people are interested, or no, they're not interested. So then we can follow up further and market further with them. Now, that is a very quick overview of Mailchimp surveys. It's very new. It came out yesterday, Australia time. So it might change a little bit over time, but it is very, very awesome. And I'm very excited about it. But I'm Gary from Organic Web, and thank you for joining me.